folks, today is one of those days where every single thing seems to be happening all at the same time. It's all hitting us all of a sudden. But it's mostly good news today. Earlier, we talked about old Donnie taking a big fat L, and now we're focusing in on the liar from Long Island, George Santos, who just did something shocking in an effort to avoid accountability based on his record and based on his principles or lack thereof. What he's doing is shocking, and it's connected to the fact that he just got indicted. Now, we don't know the specific details of the indictment yet because it's under seal, but it's almost certainly got something to do with election finance fraud or election finance lying or what have you, because most of the lies this guy told, while despicable, were not necessarily illegal. It's not illegal to lie about your educational credentials, you know, in an election, but it is illegal to make up fake donors and make up fake donation amounts and make up fake expenditure amounts, or potentially to lie to donors to get their money. And so the following explains just how screwed George Santos is, but it ends, guys. It builds to what Santos has just been caught doing, trying to flee accountability on a national level. And it comes from a top Democrat dropping a bombshell. Guys, George Santos will do anything to avoid accountability. He's already gone to Brazil once to do that and left Brazil. He's going to do it again.
This is CNN Breaking News.
And we're back with breaking news, different breaking news. A CNN exclusive, Republican Congressman George Santos of New York is now facing criminal charges. Sources telling CNN's Evan Perez that federal prosecutors have filed charges against the New York freshman and serial liar. He's expected to appear in court as soon as tomorrow. Let's bring in Evan Perez, who's breaking the story for us. Evan, tell us more. What do we know about the charges specifically?
Well, Jake, right now, we do not know the exact nature of these charges. We know that these have been filed under seal with the federal court in the Eastern District of New York. That the congressman for a number of allegations, including charges or claims, that he falsified some of his campaign finance filings. And so those are among the things that we expect prosecutors may be able to shed some more light on when we see these charges finally announced tomorrow. Now, this is a congressman, obviously, Jake, that you've talked about many, many times on this program. He took office just in January. And in just a few months, of course, it's come to light a number, just a stunning number of falsehoods and lies that he's told as part of his campaign and the lead up to his campaign and in the years prior. I'll just recite just a few of them, including his claim on his resume that he worked at Goldman Sachs and Citibank. He said that he played, he was a star volleyball player for Baruch College, which where he said he got a degree. None of those things were true. He claimed, obviously, that also that he had Jewish heritage, something, again, that has been shown to be false. And, you know, the congressman has repeatedly said that he is not a criminal, that he's not been charged.
George Santos is just a somebody who has lied left and right. And I think, you know, the question, of course, is what the charges are, right? And I think, you know, one obvious charge here is going to be a campaign finance case, because it sure looks like he was using, you know, various entities as his own piggy bank. So that's one possibility, but with somebody like him, fraud is always on the table as well.
Right. As you say, false statements to the government are chargeable, and campaign finance laws are supposed to be pretty strict about what you report, what you say, what it's for. Fraud is lying in business. That's something many people have colloquially, of course, heard of. There is initial reporting by CNN that we have not confirmed. So again, I want to be clear about the sourcing, which indicates that the prosecutors in both the public integrity unit, as well as locally in New York, have been reviewing the case and have examined at least, quote, allegations of false statements. That reporting, again, doesn't stipulate whether that's what he was ultimately charged on, but it does say that's something prosecutors were looking at. In your experience, Renato, is that something you'd want to see reviewed here? And what does it mean when they move on this? Is it going to be one small thing, or you think they have to feel they have a really strong and fulsome case?
Yeah, so usually for a case like this, they're going to, it's going to be vetted by multiple layers of review. This is not just going to be a couple prosecutors at the U.S. Attorney's Office who decided that they had enough evidence to indict. This would go all the way up to the United States Attorney in that office, and then it would go to the Public Integrity Section in D.C., and they would have to sign off on this. I would not be surprised if the Attorney General or Deputy Attorney General was also involved in this decision. I would expect that, frankly. So I think very well vetted indictment. But also, I think the question here with Santos is, would he be able to get through a trial without potentially getting wrapped up with more false statements? I mean, he's somebody who has a lot of trouble keeping his story straight. He has so many lies for so many different subjects.
Yeah.
I think it's going to be very difficult for him to get through a trial.
We've been listening here to federal prosecutor Renato Mariotti, who jumped on the phone. Stay with me, Renato. I also have MSNBC analyst and former federal prosecutor Joyce Vance. Joyce, your response to this news, which just crossed the wires breaking moments ago, controversial Republican Congressman George Santos federally indicted.
So we know that there is an indictment, but it is still under seal, which means we don't know the specifics of the charges. I think Renato is correct, though. It appeared that the Public Integrity Section, that's a group inside of Main Justice in Washington that's often involved when political figures are under investigation. And it was clear that they were looking at some sort of false statements on campaign finance submissions. That's likely the core of these charges here. But because this involves a sitting member of Congress, this was absolutely reviewed in top offices at DOJ before the U.S. attorney in New York and before the Public Integrity Section would have made a final decision. They would have sent what's called an urgent report to the Deputy Attorney General's office. And Lisa Monaco, if she wasn't in the loop earlier, which I suspect she was, at that point would have reviewed the indictment. And so a decision would have been made together before this case moved forward. This means that these charges have been very well vetted. I wouldn't be surprised if the Solicitor General was also in the mix to make sure that they were charges that would have no legal issues getting in the way if there's an appeal.
Well, I think you answered your question but I hear what you're saying. Let's bring in former federal prosecutor Ellie Honig. Ellie, how serious of a legal case could this be?
Well, Jake, I guess that'll be the big thing that we find out tomorrow when we take a look at this indictment. Important to understand, it is not a crime to lie to the public. It is not a crime to lie about what you're going to do when you get in office. It's not a crime to lie about your background. What is a crime, however, and what might be the case here, we don't know, is to lie in your Federal Election Commission filings, to lie about your campaign expenditures. And you'll recall there was reporting that George Santos's campaign claimed this whole series of expenditures for $199 because the limit over which you have to detail those expenditures is $200. I think that was awfully suspicious. So I'd be looking for some sort of official false statements charge here. Again, we're speculating, but based on what the public reporting is.
CNN Chief Legal Analyst Laura Coates is also joining us again. Laura, sorry, I thought you were going to get the hour off after all of our Trump conversation, but now we have another legal matter dealing with a different lying New York politician. How is this going to play out in court when Santos appears as soon as tomorrow? Obviously, we don't know the charges, but walk us through the choreography, if you would.
Well, first, we're going to know more about the actual charges, if it's sealed, of course, if it's what they're going to actually release to the public and what a judge would know about an arraignment and whether this is going to be a multiple indictment or one or more. Remember, you can oftentimes amend an indictment to include more offenses later on. There might be conversations already about the grand jury testimony that came in if there was a grand jury impaneled in this particular matter. And we're going to learn more about this, frankly, likely as George Santos does. But as Ellie articulated, the nature of the charges, the number of the charges might not be known, but certainly the substance of what we know to be the underlying cause for the investigation has been quite clear. And if you follow the trail of money, the idea of thinking about whether transparency and accountability can be actually served for the electorate, that's going to be the key for any campaign finance or election-related matter. What was known, what was relayed to the public, and did the electorate have a meaningful opportunity to elect a candidate of their choosing based on verifiable, truthful information? We take election-related matters very seriously in this country because we want to have that level of transparency and accountability and the access to having someone you want in office. And remember, Speaker McCarthy was very reluctant to say what they would do about this seat. trying to kick the can down the road to suggest that if there was a crime that occurred, then they would take action. Well, if the domino begins to fall and the charges come in criminally, the question I have is how will this actually manifest politically? And for the questions and reasons that Evan said, the idea of having an open seat in this instance when you had the potential for a Democrat to come in and claim it is going to be quite odd in this new Congress.
And Ellie Honig, I think
it's about ΕΣαντοΙς in his past. The congressman did decide to break his seemingly typical policy of silence and respond to this one, tweeting out earlier today the most recent obsession from the media claiming that I am a drag queen or performed as a drag queen is categorically false. The media continues to make outrageous claims about my life while I'm working to deliver results. I will not be distracted nor fazed by this. But what about this theory that he might flee? Now, some might suggest this is just sour grapes on the Democrats' part. After all, Lafazan ran for the very congressional seat that ΕΣαντοΙς eventually won just a couple of months ago. Let's ask him. Joining us now is Nassau County legislator Josh Lafazan. Thanks a lot for coming in. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me on the show.
All right. So you actually think that he's going to flee the country?
I do.
Why?
George ΕΣαντοΙς is the biggest fraud in modern political American history. It's naive to believe that this story doesn't end with him trying to shirk accountability. And if Carlos Ghosn could escape Japan in an audio equipment box, then George ΕΣαντοΙς can fly coach to Moscow.
So do they want him there, though? Like, would they welcome him in Moscow?
Quite frankly, George ΕΣαντοΙς, and nobody knows who he is.
Yeah.
Right. He's under local, state, federal, and international investigations. And an indictment is not a matter of if, but it's a matter of when.